How to tell if your kidneys are working properly. There are some early signs and symptoms of kidney disease that could warn you of possible problems. With kidney disease, an early detection is as important as hard to do. In this short video, I'll show you how to understand what your body is trying to tell you about the health of your kidneys. Hello, how are your kidneys doing? This is Catherine. Welcome to 00 Kidney. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm really glad to be here today. This is a very important topic, and I'll try to be as clear and concise as possible. The kidneys are said to be two bean-shaped organs that work like a filter. But there is a lot more, in fact. We could say that the kidneys are more like the plunger in a French coffee press. They take the grounds out of the coffee and leave you with good, drinkable coffee without any residue in it. It's a very delicate balance. How to tell if this precious balance is compromised? This is not always easy. Chronic kidney disease is said to be a silent disease, and most of the symptoms are only visible when it's in an advanced stage. But there are still some early symptoms we can consider if we want to outsmart this dangerous illness. So let's go through the various stages and see what symptoms are we gonna see in each one of them. In stage 1, the kidneys are still working. GFR is over 90. Meaning that the kidneys are healthy, still working properly. GFR is glomeruli filtration rate. It tells us, in percentage, how much the kidneys are working. If someone has both kidneys healthy, this person has 100% kidney function and GFR of 100. If GFR is over 90 or more, stage 1, the kidneys are still healthy. In stage 2, there's still not much to see. GFR is between 60 and 89, and the kidneys are still working good enough not to create any serious buildup in the body. If chronic kidney disease is diagnosed at this stage, it is usually due to other factors, like for example a physical kidney damage, like scars or proteins in the urine. Foamy urine can tell us that there is a leakage of a specific protein, albumin, in the urine. This is one of the first visible signs of kidney disease. If this happens to you, don't worry. The possibility to improve is still great. It is never too late to change things like lifestyle and diet, and there are treatments that actually work. The main focus of a treatment for this stage is to take care of the causes of kidney disease, usually diabetes or high blood pressure. But the fact that you are watching this video already proves that you are on the right way to be healthy. A healthy diet, healthy body weight, and regular physical exercise can make our kidneys go for a very long time. Now, let's go with the symptoms. Stage 3. If GFR is between 59 and 30, the kidneys are starting to fail. More symptoms will be visible and there will be complications. Again, GFR means how much in percentage the kidneys are working, so the lower it gets, the more troubles we are going to see. Still, chronic kidney disease is a silent disease. Patients with only non-specific symptoms are still common even with stage 3 kidney disease and GFR of 40 or 50. This is a great risk because people often let the disease progress unnoticed until stage 4 or even 5. Some say that the sickest kidney is still smarter than the smartest doctor. It can still do enough to keep you alive. But some symptoms are more recognizable than others. In stage 3 of CKD, we are going to see a condition called uremia. That means level of waste in blood abnormally high. We sometimes use the phrase urine in blood to try to make this more comprehensible for patients. The toxins the body is supposed to remove through the urine are in fact still in the blood. These wastes are going to cause several other symptoms, Swelling in the feet and hands and even face are usually one of the first things that get noticed. These fluid buildups are even going to cause trouble breathing and ammonia breath. Ammonia breath is a very noticeable symptom, and it's the reason why doctors are able to tell if you have CKD just by smell. Ammonia breath is often accompanied by a metallic taste in the mouth and loss of appetite. Another recognizable symptom is the change in the urination patterns. Some patients are going to use the bathroom several times during the night, a symptom called nocturia. The shift of position of the body lying down will cause the circulation to start concentrating in the kidneys area, and the kidneys will try to process a lot of wastes created during the day, making the patient want to go to the bathroom even 8 or 10 times a night. Another symptom of stage 3 kidney disease is foamy urine, like in stage 2. Now, we are not talking about some bubbles in the urine here, which is perfectly normal, but if you see a foam of similar to what you can find on the top of freshly spilled beer, that definitely could be proteinuria. Now, how is it possible that someone went from stage 2 to 3 without noticing all this foam and bubbles in the urine? The issue is that many people don't want to listen to what their body is telling them. Let me explain with a story. A friend of mine was driving to California when he began to smell something coming from his car, an acrid smell. Ah, California is well known for its smog, he thought, and went on with his trip. But it wasn't the smog, it was the engine. After several miles, the car finally broke down, costing him thousands of dollars to fix it. The point is that if he didn't forget to get it checked and recognize the smell, he could have saved his car that day. This is why you should be listening to what your body is trying to tell you about your kidneys. A lot of people think that if they pretend it isn't there, the ailment will go away by itself. This doesn't always work, unfortunately. We must learn the habit of paying attention to our bodies. The first we start fighting the disease instead of just ignoring it, the more chance of victory we have. Another very recognizable symptom is kidney pain. It is important to recognize kidney pain from musculoskeletal back pain. Kidney pain is felt on the flank of the body, between the bottom of the rib cage and the hips, in higher position than musculoskeletal back pain. Movement won't make it better or worse. Only the correct treatment can alleviate it. Kidney pain is more common in stage 4 patients. Stage 4 is defined by GFR between 30 and 15, meaning that the kidneys are only operating at the 30 to 15% of their normal regime. The waste buildups are going to be worse and the symptoms are going to be more noticeable. Nausea, loss of appetite, fatigue, and mental confusion are to be expected. In stage 5, when the GFR drops below 15, the kidneys aren't working like they should anymore. Patients at this stage are usually required to undergo dialysis or to prepare for a kidney transplant if they are able to find a donor. This is not a death sentence, as many people seem to think. There's still hope, and living a normal life is not impossible. Your nephrologist may recommend you to get tested regularly and to follow a specific kidney-friendly diet. Another very important thing to do is to completely stop the use of NSAIDs. These drugs are often used to control pain, but are known to cause damages to the kidneys and should be avoided by all kidney patients. Blood pressure is another thing to keep under strict control. If your doctor prescribed you any medication, stick to it. Get checked regularly because high blood pressure can damage the vessels carrying blood through the kidneys and making things even worse. So never lose hope, but don't underestimate the symptoms either. And remember that if you take care of your body, things can always get better. This is all for today. If you like this video, please like and leave a comment. Thank you for watching.